Good morning, everyone. I am Chef Manpreet, and I am working as an assistant professor in Kara University. Okay, so today's topic is basically standard of professionalism, and we will discuss about what are the basic traits and principles are required in the kitchen while working in the sophisticated area. So learning objective of this chapter are these are the learning objective levels and skills required in a kitchen and attitude and behavior, attitude and professionalism in the kitchen and principles in the professional kitchens. Okay, and the uniform, the basic uniform which we wear in the kitchen, what is the role and how this uniform protect us from various like incidents happens in the kitchen. Okay, first of all, this is the levels and skills which is required in the professional setup. So as we know that kitchen where we are working at our homes, that is a small kitchen and that is not a professional kitchen. But once you entered in the professional setup, that is hotel kitchens, totally different. So these are the four P's which is required in the professional setups, like product, process, profit and people. So product here is we are talking about food. Food is a most important thing which is we are serving to the guest and which is plays a very important role. If food is not excellent and food is not presentable, then definitely though no customer will come inside in the restaurant to wine and dine. So paramount importance is we have to serve the food in that way that it has to be excellent in the quality and it has to be prepared hygienically, because nowadays the coronavirus is all around the globe and we know the hygiene and sanitization is very, very important, which is nowadays it is very important aspect. So we have to take care of the hygiene as well as the quality of the product we have to maintain. And next is process. Yes, standardization is one of the major enemy and major you can say barrier which has been faced by different hotels or different restaurants. Those who are like preparing a food on a regular basis, they are not even know about that how the food will taste at the end of the day. So each and every time they have to follow the process. Okay, they have to follow each and every step which has been followed by before. So that is why the results at the end of the day we will get each and every time the same, and providing the same quality and taste and garnishing and each and everything to the customer in the same way. And the profit, definitely the business required profit. Any commercial organization or hotel runs for a profit. Yes, the paramount importance is fine. We have to provide services to the guest and it has to be a wow experience we have to provide at the end of the day. But we have to provide a profit also. Okay, we have to take a profit out from the business. If we are not getting a profit, a good profit, then we are not able to run our business in a right manner. And the next P is people. The rest three P's will not work if people, the human touch is not involved for the presentations or for the preparations, then the rest three P's are not in the room. So people are very, very important in the kitchen. Those who are working in and preparing the food and serving the food to the guests. So these are very, very important. People plays a very important role. So they have to be there in the kitchen. And people, we will discuss these people, those who are like present, the hierarchy, we will discuss in the later PPT. But today the people we are talking about, the people, those who are working in the kitchen, and they are most important for rest of the P. And to make the profitable business without these people is not possible. Attitude and behavior in the kitchen is very, very important. Why? Because kitchen is basically a dangerous area to work in. There are a lot of sophisticated machinery which we have to deal with on a regular basis. So we have to be very much cautious about it that while working with those sophisticated or integrated machinery. So while working in the kitchen, we have to follow different kind of rules and regulations which has been given by given by the senior chefs or which has been given by the manual which are attached with the sophisticated machinery. If one or individual or personal, those who are working in a kitchen, are not following those rules and regulation, then definitely it will turns to be a accident or incident in the kitchen. So these are the rules which we have to follow. These are the rules which we have to taken care. First one is distraction. Distraction is one of the most important thing, and it will occur due to the persons or other person, those who are working along with you. So distraction would not be happen in the kitchen. If you are working on some particular task, then you have to concentrate on that particular job only. Okay, if you are like distracted with some other person and you are talking with some other person while doing something, then definitely it will end up or land it to be fatal. Okay, so you have to be not distracted in a kitchen. For example, while slicing onion by a chef and he is talking to someone, it will leads to be a fatal in the situation. So it will definitely cut your hand. So do not be get distracted while you are working in a kitchen along with the sophisticated machineries or crude tools which you are using. Next, the most important and the that is basically a second point, haste, and which we have to be taken care, and this is the most important enemy of the kitchen. Okay, if haste is there, then definitely we will not able to prepare the food in a right manner. So haste should not be there in the kitchen. While you are working in a kitchen, the each and everything, the mise has to be planned in a proper way. Mise means we have to go through with the ingredients what is required for the preparation of that particular recipe. So each and everything should be done in a proper way, in a proper planned way. Okay, and then it should be put in a tray, and it has to be put nearby to your range, within your access, and it should be in your reach. Otherwise you would not be able to prepare your food in a right manner, and you will run away in the kitchen from one place to another place to get the ingredient at your reach. So this is one of the most important thing which you have to be keep in your mind while working or preparing any dish. You have to keep all the ingredients within your reach so that the haste would not be happen during the cooking processes. Okay, so this is the last attitude which is required in the kitchen, failure to observe rules and regulations, which is also very very important rule which we have to follow in the kitchen. If some personnel, those who are working in the kitchen, are not following the rules and regulations which has been given by their senior chefs, or while using any kind of integrated machinery or sophisticated machinery, they are not following the manuals which has been given by manufacturers, then it will leads to be a fatal. Okay, while you are not following those rules, then definitely it will create a hassle, or it will create a accident to the personals in the kitchen. So we have to follow each and every time the rules and regulations. For example, while you are extracting a juice from a juice machine, okay, you are one has to use a pusher for pushing the fruits inside. Okay, if you are using your bare hands to push the fruit inside, then definitely you will lose your finger or even hand. So it is very very important that you have to use only those kind of equipments which are meant for, and the manual has to be taken care, or manual has to be gone through if any kind of deviation has been occurred in your mind. So this is really a very important thing. Now moving ahead here, we are having a kitchen rules which every chef has to follow. These are the rules which we have to be taken care before entering in the professional setups. The rule number one, kitchen rule number one, is allow enough time to read and prepare well in advance the day earlier for the task waking to done in the next day. So it is really very important while you are working in the kitchen, you have to provide enough time. Okay, you have to take enough time to complete each and everything. You have to go through with the menu, you have to go through with the ingredients which is required for the preparation of that particular menu. So everything has to be done in a pre-planned way. So then only you will able to prepare your food, or you will prepare your whatever the task in a proper manner. And rule number two, plan your work. So before proceeding, you have to proceed in a logical order which is taught to you. Okay, the menu which is like displayed in front of you, you have to check that which recipe or which dish has to be prepared first and which dish has to be prepared in the last. So this is the basic logical manner or order which we have to use in the kitchen. Okay, if we are not using this rule, then we are not able to prepare the food in a right manner. Yes, the old saying here, if you having a blunt knife, then it will cuts your hand. Okay, so sharp knife definitely cuts the vegetable, but the blunt knife will cuts your hand. So it's an old saying. So always keep your knives and shears or tools which is required to cut the vegetables. It should be sharp enough, it should be well maintained, okay, which will helps you to work you in the kitchen for in a better way or produce a better results. Okay, keep your knives and shears in an organized manner or a clean manner. Rule number four, you have to use the appropriate equipments and appropriate sanitized equipment. Now we are in that stage in the all around the globe where these kind of things like pandemic is going on. Due to that reason, almost all around the globe is in a lockdown situation. So if we are not using a sanitized equipment or clean equipment, then definitely it will lead to be a food poisoning, or it will leads to be a in a different situation. So always you have to use a clean and sanitized equipment for the preparation of any food in the kitchen, and use appropriate tools and appropriate equipment which is required for the preparation of that dish. It is also very, very important. Rule number five, always clean, work clean and clean as you go. So cleaning and hygiene, as I have already spoken, that cleaning and hygiene is very, very important aspect in the kitchen. If you are not cleaning yourself and around yourself, your surrounding areas are not properly clean, then definitely it will leads to be a bad situation to the company as well as to the other people. So while you are working, this is your responsibility as a food handler. You have to check your hygiene and your subordinates, your superiors, your juniors, each and every person has to be in a proper maintained hygiene. Hygiene and cleaning basically works working habit. It should be natural habit. Do not wait for someone else to do or teach you. You have to learn with your own experiences, and it will comes within you. Okay, so you have to be hygienic while you are working in the kitchen. This is really very important in the kitchen nowadays. Rule number six, respect your ingredients. Yes, ingredients are one of the most important aspect in the food production. We are processing the ingredients. Whatever the ingredients are reached at our hotel or at our doorstep in the kitchen, then this is our responsibility that we have to look after in a very logical way. Okay, every ingredient is incurred with some amount of money. So each and every ingredient is very much expensive. So expensive, we have to treat with very much of care and passion. Okay, and only one would be see great quality in the dish while you are producing it. Okay, so if you are using your ingredient with proper zeal and passion, at the end of the day, the results will be good. Rule number seven, store all the food ingredients in a proper manner. This is also very, very important. The food contamination may be occurred due to not handling the food in a right manner, if you are not handling a cooked food or raw food in a right manner, then it will leads to be a great contamination to the food. So while any kind of ingredients which are present in your kitchen, you should have a knowledge about that, how the food has to be stored, on which temperature we have to store the food. Okay, so this is a food handler responsibility. Once the ingredient has been handed over to you, then you have to store those ingredients according to the international standards. Otherwise, if you put at an ambient temperature, at a room temperature, then it will turns to be contaminated with the perishable and highly perishable food products. Rule number eight, this is the old saying, everyone says that practice makes the man perfect. So everyone has to do that, they have to do the practice all the time. So kitchen also required the practice each and every time. If you are not doing practice with the skills of cutting and chopping, then at the end of the day, you would not be able to be a skillful person. So all great skills and art required a lot of dedications and lot of efforts is required in the kitchen. So never give up. You have to be have a zeal in you. Rule number nine, it is also very, very important. Cooking is not basically a profession or it is not a job. It is basically a passion and pleasure and fun. Okay, if you enjoy cooking and enjoy yourself and have fun, then cooking is not a profession. So you have to be like you have to enjoy your cooking, and it is a way of life. It's a way of living. Now moving ahead, we have reached here the importance of uniform in the kitchen. Kitchen has different components of kitchen uniform. It will starts from chef jacket, and chef jacket is which is I am wearing also, that is chef coat, and it is also known as called chef jacket, which is thick, made up of cotton, and 100% cotton is there. Why? Because we have to the kitchen personnel has to work in a hot area where all the time sweating and all these kind of things would be happen. So it will helps you to keep your or maintain your temperature at a right temperature, and the kitchen personnel can work inside in the kitchen properly. So it is very, very important you have to wear it, and there's some other reasons why you have to use the white one, because white one is the symbolic of hygiene, and it also repels the heat. The white one will helps in what? It will repels the heat rather than absorbing the heat inside. So it will keep your body temperature maintained all the time in the kitchen. Okay, and it is double breasted from the front. There are two thick layers are there in the front, which will helps you from the heat stroke, which will comes from the heat generating equipments. You have to work all the time in the kitchen in front of ranges, which is producing a heat stroke all the time. And definitely, this chef jacket will protect your vital organs from the heat stroke. Okay, and the chef trouser has different styles. There are two different types of pants are worn by different people in the kitchen. One is checked one and one is black one. The checked one is having basically worn by according to the hierarchy also, but in some hotels this classical checked one is used for camouflage of different kind of spills which is found in the kitchen. So sometimes in some hotels chef trouser is basically meant for to denotes your designations also. If you are wearing a black one, then it will be considered to be as an executive, and rest other people are wearing a checked one. Chef hat, which is worn on the top of your head by the chef, and this is one of the most important component of the kitchen uniform, and it has to be worn each and every time in the kitchen. So the main function of chef hat is to keep your hair inside in the hat, so that the hair will not be fall inside in the food. If any kind of hair is found in the food that will be considered as unhygienic food. So the main focus, the main purpose of Chef Hat is to keep your hair in. So that is why we have to wear. And all the sweating which will come over your overhead, it will be also absorbed by this Chef Hat. Next is scarf or neckerchief. So this is basically worn around your neck area where we have to wear this. Okay, there are so many different types of colors are present in the kitchen, and it also denotes your designation in the kitchen. So as per your designation, you have to wear it. Okay, so scarf is also denoting your designation. Thus, one other function of scarf is the perspirations and the sweating which will comes around your neck will be absorbed by this neckerchief or scarf. Okay, and next one is apron. Apron is worn around your waist. Okay, and this apron is a long thick cotton piece of cloth having two strings on the both sides, and these two strings will helps you or facilitate you to tied around your waist properly, and this will helps you from the hot spills which is present in the kitchen. If anything spills on you or on the chef, then this apron will definitely protect from the spilling of any kind of hot liquids. And next one is kitchen towel or duster. Kitchen towel or duster plays a very, very important role in the kitchen, and without this, the one or chef would not be able to work in, because each and every time chef has to work with the hot equipments and hot pot and pans which has to be held by his hand. So while the hot pans and different kind of stock pots are there, you are not able to hold it with your bare hands. So you require some kind of protective gears during that period of time. So this duster will helps you to keep your hands protected from the hot pans and pots in the kitchen. And the last one is shoes. Shoes is one of the most important aspect in the chef uniform, which plays a very important role. You have to worn shoes which is very much comfortable in nature, because we have to, the kitchen staff has to stand for about continuously stand for 7 to 8 hours. Okay, so we have to be wear those shoes which is comfortable in nature. And yes, the sole has to be made up of rubber, which is which will helps you to provide a proper amount of grip while you are working in the kitchen. Otherwise you will slip, because there are a lot of different kind of liquids are there in the floor of the kitchen, like oils and water is there. So we have to use those kind of shoes which will provide you the grip in the kitchen. So thank you so much guys for watching me, and this is done, and thank you so much.